I was in London. I was hosting a party at Club K in Hounslow. The DJ, first record he played, Bobby Shmurda Hot. The whole club wildin'.
London.
London.
Bobby let a lot of soak up his energy for months. The most do is they throw him up on a story, real with some random emoji. They don't even mention the music coming out. All these like, yo, Bobby's a real one. You know how they repaid Bobby? Yo, I had a show and I just brought Bobby out. I'm so sick of it, of everybody just tagging on Bobby as a special guest. How about if y'all want to show him love, he headlined this.
Nothing can throw a spanner in the works of a promising MC's career quite like an extended spell in prison. Suddenly robbed of your freedom just as your prospects in life had begun to look brighter than ever, finding yourself behind bars has been a key component in the journeys of many MCs, past and present. For some, it could be a difficult period of self-reflection in which the next phase of their career is mapped out in their heads. While for others such as LA's Draco the Ruler, who famously recorded 2020's Thank You for Using GTL tape over the phone during his time in custody, they'll do whatever it takes to keep making their presence felt in the world. Other times, the creative fire is extinguished by the experience of doing time, and they're never the same afterwards. In this instance, a once chart-topping MC turned Belizean politician such as Shine would be a prime example. But for Brooklyn's own Bobby Shmurda, his case is one which is baffling onlookers in real time. As while the world was waiting to find out what was next for the leader of the GS9, the results have left the drill pioneer with a lower profile and degree of investment from hip-hop than he did when he was still behind bars. As while he was hailed as a hero for accepting extra time on his sentence in order to allow his GS9 brother and fellow MC Rowdy Rebel to get out sooner, the return of the man who was largely accredited with waking NYC hip-hop up from a state of stagnancy is now facing it in his own right. And by all accounts, this has been sparked from the very moment that he touched down as a free man. Initially picked up by Quavo of Migos on a private jet, Bobby was welcomed back to hip-hop as an all-conquering hero, and his footage of him recording from home in order to meet the terms of his probation surfaced, everyone expected to hear from him sooner rather than later. But from here on out, it was clear that Shmurda would take a different and ultimately less attention-grabbing route than many rappers before him. First brought into the culture by Gucci Mane in 2009 before being mimicked by everyone from Kodak Black to T Grizzly and JT from the City Girls, among many, many others, Bobby opted to forgo the tradition of the first day out freestyle, and at the time, everyone figured that it must have been a tactical move. After all, where MCs such as Draco, Lil Boosie, C Murda, and NBA Youngboy released music while behind bars, Shmurda stayed silent, completely silent, save for the feature on Tekashi 6ix9ine's Stupid that he's since admitted that he regrets.
Would you do a song with Tekashi after you got out?
But nowadays, reports have suggested that the delay was actually caused by friction with his label, Epic Records. Since that legendary video of him dancing on the table in their offices hit our screens, it seems that Bobby and his backers at Epic have had a love-hate relationship. When I got locked up, I thought they were going to come for me, Bobby informed the New York Times from the Manhattan detention complex after his initial arrest in 2015. But they never came. They told me they were going to help me make myself a star in the business for a decade. I'm going to try my best to go back on the deal, he continued. If not, I'll give them their music and bounce. Although he's since claimed that he's still rocking with them, a report from 2Beast TV from March 2021 suggested that there's still a recurring issue. Armed with a street mentality in a corporate world, it's entirely possible that there's been an intervention on the label's part that could have been avoided if he'd simply turned down the big offers when Hot briefly became the biggest track in the world. As now, it appears that there's a gap between how he's regarded in the commercial space and how hip-hop's community gauges star power. Considering that he's had all of the admiration of the streets for how he handled himself, all dispatches from the hip-hop world pointed to a new lease on life, and his music experienced a streaming boom of 624% in the days after he stepped out of the penitentiary. But in a world in which the profit margins in hip-hop are largely controlled by suburban areas, his respect in New York counts for a lot less in the marketplace than it perhaps should. And now, Bobby's inability to do exactly what he wants has likely contributed to him floundering. Speaking way back in 2014, Charlamagne had previously expressed concerns about him shackling himself to a label and suggested that it only made sense if his plan was to be a one-hit wonder.
My only thing, and I think he should have stayed independent unless Epic gave him a nice check. We've seen people like Trinidad James. You can say whatever you want about Trinidad James, but if he got $2 million for damn near a single, which, because that's all he had was that one record, salute to him. I'm not mad at him. Take that money and run. Same thing with Bobby Shmurda. If they gave him some nice six, seven figure money, take it and run.
Well, you know, I had heard that Drake and French Montana are on the remix.
Wow. That's going to take that record to another place then. I like what Bobby Shmurda's doing. I like the energy, man. Have fun, man.
Despite Vlad's comments, that remix never came to fruition. And while Bobby likely has no intention of being defined by his past in the way that Mr. All Gold Everything is, his chances of avoiding that fate are diminishing. Now, the man that was previously responsible for what is arguably the most iconic snippet in hip-hop history seems to have blended into the crowd. With fans expressing their concern, the emergence of a new teaser of music from Shmurda prompted academics to argue that Bobby is now missing the vibrancy that had once set him apart.
Oh man, if you're gonna give us a snippet, you know how to do it. Bobby, you know the energy we need. We want that Brooklyn rowdy lit, like all up in the, like that's what we want, bro. Like we don't want this, like you're cool, like you ain't Quavo, the you Jamaican too, like you a rude boy, dog. Like who we had the dog? Bobby, I love you. I love you so much, bro. I'm gonna keep it real with you. Don't want to hear how much money you got. We just seen the trial. You were broke as a joke. We want to hear that you were struggling. We want you to still be on that like ribs touching. We want to hear like, yo, you've been in jail and you've been hungry. Bro, we want the hungry music. I don't care how many chains you got on your neck.
With this tonal shift in Bobby's work causing a lot of concern, Ack's outline of his issues with where he's headed has actually echoed a lot of the sentiments of many fans who were unmoved by what's come out so far. Prior to anything actually being distributed to the world, Bobby had hyped up his new output at every conceivable opportunity, and in doing so, created massive expectations for what was to come.
Man, we got so much new music coming. It's like the guy's music with the biggest artist.
That's
man.
A fact.
From Maino, the Baby, the 42, Uzi, Rowdies, just Jay.
Shout out to Rowdy, man.
Everybody, man. There's so much coming out. It's going to be a hot summer. It's going to be a hot summer. It's going to be rapid.
And just as the high-profile collab with Drake and French that DJ Vlad had alluded to in the past didn't pan out, all of these blockbuster link-ups have yet to see the light of day. None of his post-prison tracks have hit it out of the park as of yet. And even now, there's been a drastic decline between the numbers that his reintroduction of No Time for Sleep freestyle commanded in comparison to recent offerings such as Splash and Cartier Lens. Where that first track spread like wildfire and left many disappointed, the other seemed to be only appearing on the radars for those who were going out of their way to keep checking for him. For example, while No Time for Sleep freestyle has racked up over 12 million views and counting, October's Cartier Lens has stalled around 650,000. As a result of the growing discontent around his new tracks, Bobby's yet to chart in anything other than the bubbling under Hot 100, and as for the comments, it's obvious that indifference and disappointment are the two prevailing emotions. Bobby's flow still doing 5-10 in prison, read one remark out of the hundreds that were left deflated by the track. Chiming in once again, academics claimed that not only have tactical errors allowed him to be usurped by his fellow GS9 brother, but that the love that he'd been showered in as he emerged from the pen was more about what other rappers in the industry could get out of him rather than helping.
Yo, Bobby, I'm gonna keep it 1,000 with you. These industry is jumping next to you because they don't seem gritty no more. They seem mad polished and they seem not about it. They've been trying to get to you to get some authenticity. Don't sound like them. Bobby let a lot of soak up his energy for months. And now when he's dropping music, the main attraction to his music is people looking and critiquing his dancing and movements. Yo, look at how he's dancing. That's how people saw him. Bobby f***ed up. I know he's trying to get on Rot Nation. He should have just stayed low. Even though I thought he dropped music late, if he wasn't dropping music, he should have just been out of sight. It's crazy for me to think that I think musically, people are checking for Rowdy more than Bobby. It's f***ed up. I don't even know what to say. I feel like Bobby has played this whole, he's played this whole thing wrong. We heard about these super hot tracks. None of them are hidden. The most do is they throw them up on a story, real with some random emoji. They don't even mention music coming out. All these like, yo, Bobby's a real one. You know how they repaid Bobby? Yo, I had a show and I just brought Bobby out. I'm so sick of it, of everybody just tagging on Bobby as a special guest. How about if y'all want to show him love, he headlined this. That's how you show him he's a big dog. Bobby Shmurda should be headlining all these shows if everybody really loved him how they were saying they do. I seen Bobby Shmurda come out of Summer Jam. He performed one song. I couldn't believe it.
In what has turned out to be almost prophetic words from Shmurda in 2017, the notion of the culture using him as a token of their own street credentials without ever giving back seems to be supported by Bobby himself.
The only one that really contacted us was 50. Anybody else, you know, they talk, man. They do it for the people. The only real one I can say is Super Dave and 50.
Left to flail around without direction at a time when he was expected to fly, Bobby's career isn't looking anywhere near as hopeful as we'd thought when he first stepped off that private plane. Fueled by a combination of mismanagement and poor decision-making on Bobby's part, he should have been informed that in this new age of hip-hop that he'd watched from the sidelines, you need to strike while the iron's hot. Beyond that, you need to come out with precisely what the people want. by not doing so, and instead choosing to experiment with flows that are too similar to other rappers that piggybacked off his wave, he has faced being cast adrift by the sheer force of the modern news cycle that is always hungry for more. As where his breakout single was given ample time to grow into the monster that it eventually became, that window has shrunk, and this meant that by not releasing a first day out freestyle or even dropping something that'd serve as a reminder of what he was capable of within the weeks after his release, that golden opportunity to capitalize on his buzz was lost. Now, with a debut record only being teased by him online and not being billed by his label as one of their landmark releases, it seems like the faith in him as a star is wavering. In spite of this, he is still a very respected figure in hip-hop, and if everyone truly wants to repay him for everything he's done, then now is the time for everyone that so persistently claims to love him to rally around him and ensure the health of his career for years to come.